Yeah, good morning, young man.
Good morning, sir.
Priyam, I see you're very smartly dressed up today. Really ready for a good interview.
Yes, sir.
Good dressing up is an indicator of a person who is well aware as to what is anticipated in a formal interview. Congratulations. Very good.
Thank you, sir.
So, Priyam, where do you come from?
Sir, I came from a very beautiful city. It's known as Chandigarh. You must have heard that city beautiful.
Oh, yeah, I have. And when we were kids, we were always told that Chandigarh is capital of Haryana and Punjab. But
yes,
unfortunately,
sir.
I've never been. Being in the Navy, I've never seen that place. So why don't you tell me something about Chandigarh?
Sir, Chandigarh is a planned city and it was a dream of our first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, that he's always wanted to be a city, to be a plant. So with the help of a French architect, he built a city, Chandigarh. And Chandigarh is a very small city, but it's fully planned. So Chandigarh is constructed in an area of 10 kilometers only. And if while standing in the center of Chandigarh, if you walk in any direction 10 kilometers, you will be you will be out of Chandigarh. Chandigarh is well connected with road as well as with it has an international airport. It has a very beautiful railway station, and all the basic and good facilities are there in Chandigarh. It also has development cells, like it has the secretariat and it has a high court, and all the basic needs that a person can have, it can be fulfilled in Chandigarh. In fact, Chandigarh has also many places of visitors. It's a visitor attraction point also. It has Sukhna Lake, which is the largest man-made lake in India. And it has the rock garden, it has rose garden, and depending upon your interest, sir, I would be glad to share more things with that what you want to visit. If you are a person who has keen interest in history, then I'll definitely take you to the museums. And if you are an adventurous person, then we have your forest and resort where a lot of adventurous activity take place. And if you're keen of learning or reading books, then we have a great library in Chandigarh also.
Excellent. Priyam, you've really given me a good insight. Not only given me a good insight, you've actually motivated me to come to Chandigarh. Priyam, do you recall who's this great man who created this city? And there are some UN heritage sites also in Chandigarh.
So, I have a little idea. He's Lee Grand Tome, something like that. It's a French name, so I don't remember. I'm not that good in remembering names.
Shakespeare said, what is there in the name? Not to worry. So Priyam, thank you very much for telling me something very interesting about your city. Priyam, but as you know that to every rose there is a thorn.
Yes, sir.
So tell me three reasons why I should not come to your city.
Sir, if you're a person who is like to break rules, then you should never visit Chandigarh because the rules are very strict in Chandigarh. If you're a person who like to roam late night and are in late night roamings on street, and if you are a person who is like very social, like he wants to get around with people in late nights and walk and break the rules, then you should never visit Chandigarh. And if you are a person who is if a person who wants some kind of physical activities, who wants like hanging around people, and if you want to visit mountains, you should never come to Chandigarh because Chandigarh don't have mountains. If you're a person who likes snows.
So, thank you very much, Priyam. So I understand that to come to Chandigarh, I have to be more disciplined than what I am. Thank you very much. And I'm sure that when I come there, I'll keep all these things in my mind. Thank you.
Sir.
Priyam, so in the next 20 minutes or so, we'll be interacting and I'll be very keen to know. Yes, sir. So looking at your education, your family, and certain areas of interest.
Okay, sir.
So, Priyam, tell me, suppose if you tell me of your education,
yes,
starting
sir.
From class 10th to your present level.
Yes, sir.
I will be interested in knowing the percentages of marks that you got in each class, subject that you selected in class 11th, your future career options. So let me know of all the competitive exams that you appeared in and results thereof. To let me know the teachers who have impressed you, and at times the teachers don't impress also. Do let me know of them also. And similarly, make a mention of your friend circle. You being so smart, you will be having a lot of friends or boys and girls, reasons why they are close to you and some who are not close. Do let me know of your achievement in sports, extracurricular, co-curricular activities, and how was your education financed? Understood better?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all yours, Priyam. Go ahead.
So let me start from my education. I've done my education from Army Public School, Ambala Khand. So in Army Public School, sir, you have, I'm speaking about my 10th class, so you have to be good, you have to score good marks for that, so that you can get admissions to class 11. So because of that, I really worked hard and I got a good marks. I got 8.2 CGPA, which is quite good for me. And then depending upon my interest, because I was very much into science and all, I used to think that how things really works. Like normally a person switch on the fan and the fan start working. But I was very keen in learning that how this thing happened. For instance, I was very shocked that how these things are happening. So with the help of my teachers and my own interest, I choose my science as my stream. I choose non-medical in class 11th and pursue same in class 12th also. So in class 11th also, I was very much interested in chemistry. So I studied chemistry very hard and I was like, I got around 70 marks in chemistry. 70 marks in chemistry plus 20 in that practical exam. So I scored 90 in chemistry and that was a great achievement for me. And in 12th also, I was much more interested in, I was like following my passion also side by side because I always wanted to join defense. So in 12th class, I started taking coaching for NDA and CDS. Not coaching, I used to use YouTube as my medium. So I was studying for my testes and all. So in that time, I feel many competitions formed like NDA, CDS, NDA. And JEE mains and all, but I was not able to clear any of them. I was not, my marks was not up to that much. I'm not very good in maths. At that time, I used to think I was not very good in maths because the maths they required is the basic maths, and I'm not good at recalling things much. If I have interest in something, then I can easily memorize it. So in class 12, I scored 77%, and after that, I chose engineering. And about my achievements in my class 10 to 12, I am a very good student. As an extraordinary student, I was appointed as vice prefect in class 10th, then vice captain in class 11th, and gradually district captain in class 12. I also represented in my school in NCC in 2015 as the Republic Day camp. I was also a very good sports person. I've presented in my school in sports ball and baseball.